What is up, guys? And today I'm going to be talking about my documentary process and how I got to the evaluation. And this is my actual evaluation on the documentary unit 2. We're going to be starting by looking how I reviewed my ideas, developments, and my production process. Now, my whole process, I went through it by... I started by looking at the biography and everything, and of my chosen artist. I looked at her basic, where she's from, what age she is, what type of lifestyle she had, where she worked, how did she get to where she is now. And as it went on to my final project, which was doing her album cover. Her album cover was actually influenced on the basics of her life and how her lifestyle was. I did it very jazzy and very cool and, very poppy kind of feeling to the actual, album design itself, because she was deliberate. I could say Billy Bobby. I could say Billie Holiday was the diva of the 50s in jazz, and she was one of the very first people to start the jazz industry and make it so cool and so, you know, different to the other different music genres, and that's how I came to develop my ideas in style and my production process. The second question is, how did contextual research impact on your creative development? Now, as my creative research went on, I learned more and more and more different stuff about Billy as I went on. And the more different stuff I learned about her, the more it impacted on my actual work and the different styles I put into it. At the very beginning, she was very abused. That's why I learned about her, and she didn't have really, really good parents. Her mum was really nice, but she just didn't really have a good childhood when she was a child. And at the very beginning, I had a very negative outcome on her lifestyle when she was a child and to what she is now. But now I actually get into her, and I got to know more about her and more about her lifestyle and her biography and where she came from and everything, and who she is now. It impacted big time on my final work because, you know, you just learn more and more details about her. It did impact me very big on my creative development because I did learn different aspects of her. Third question is, what resources did you use? For example, software, hardware, sources from the web. I used PowerPoint to create and understand her biography. I put some pictures. I used Google Images a lot to actually figure out who she was in person. I searched on Wikipedia a lot. Well, not a lot, but a few, just to find out her jazz career and how she found. And I could say I used a lot of jazz websites and a lot of history websites just to find out who she was in person, and a lot of people that worked with her to create who she is right now. But other than that, I watched a lot of documentaries on BBC, and that impacted that. It was very, very good that there was a lot of documentaries, so I could actually see Billy and her lifestyle and what would have looked like her lifestyle in person. Fourth question is, what were the technical methods and solutions for uploading a range of different media to your site. The technical methods for my documentary, because I was on a free template on my website, I couldn't upload anything that related to audio or video, so I had to upload it to my YouTube channel and then put the link, and that's how you put the video in into your website. I did put my documentary in like that. Because of the free template, you're allowed to put pictures and writing, so I did a lot of research. I put a lot of PowerPoints on there, screenshots of the PowerPoint. I did a lot of Word documents and take screen grabs and screenshots, and I also put them in there. I designed a lot of covers, and I designed a lot of bold ideas and raw files and put them on there too, from Adobe Photoshop and InDesign and much more. But they were, I used a lot of software. Hardware, I used a lot of USBs because I had to travel from place to place to get them. But yeah, in hardware, that's pretty much it. I also used an iMac, as you can see here. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Fifth question, what skills have you developed during this project? Reflect on your time management. The time itself, it took a couple of weeks. I did have some confusion in the middle, but I got it sorted. What skills have you developed during these projects? I think I've improved on my time management. I've also got a lot of skills on Adobe itself, Photoshop, InDesign, a lot of softwares I have improved on. Also writing, I've done a lot of writing. I haven't done a lot of writing on Word or PowerPoint for ages, so I'm getting faster on the keyboard. Also, I'm just getting to know the softwares more, and I use a lot of website designs like Wix and WordPress. I'm getting to know them a lot on the side. Getting to know, well, I am a YouTuber, but I'm getting to know, you know, on the side of it, how to upload and edit videos, which is really, really cool, and it benefits myself and my work at the same time, so I'm quite happy. Number six is review feedback received from your target audience and tutors. Yes, I have done that. Clear screen grabs. Yeah, so that's to conclude that, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next evaluation.